Yeah, when I think about life and work in New York City and how it relates to theological beliefs, mm-hmm. I think about it in a couple of ways. One is that everybody has beliefs, whether they're a Christian or not, that they can't prove and on which they base their understanding of ethics and what's important. And so for a Christian, you know, those beliefs, like everybody else, is like a scaffolding for their life, like a bridge. And the circumstances of their lives are driven over that bridge on a regular basis. But you move to New York City, you get a job here, that's like a Mack truck being driven over the bridge of your life, your beliefs. And so you may have certain beliefs that you've held your whole life about Jesus and the church and ethics, but the trials and the pace and the temptations and the struggles of New York City show the cracks. And so the need to really wrestle with those beliefs and massage them into the marrow of your life is critical. It'll crack under the pressure of a place like New York if you don't work it into your life in a deep formational way. And that can only happen in the context of a community. And so that's why it's really important that the church and things like Gotham and Center for Faith and Work allow that bridge to be fortified.